Vasudeva seeks true knowledge. As the purpose of the avatara of Sri Krishna was coming to a conclusion, the visits of Narada to Dwaraka became more frequent. On one such occasion, Vasudeva beseeched the sage for enlightenment. He said, "O sage, out of ignorance, I had been in all my previous births craving for pleasures and progeny, and I never thought of liberation. Kindly teach me the way to avoid rebirth so that I may aspire for it even now." Narada replied, "I will tell you the conversation which once took place between one king, Nimi, and a group of sages, and that will satisfy your desire." King Nimi was the ruler of Mithila. He was performing a sacrifice. 9 sages arrived at the Yajnashala. They were the saintly brothers of the famous emperor Bharata. King Nimi was delighted to have their satsang. He wanted to clear many of his doubts from them. He asked them, "What is the greatest gain a man must seek for?" Sage Kavi said, Kavi means Sarvajna, one of perfect knowledge. "An ignorant man who mistakes his body as his self should at least worship the lotus feet of the Lord Srihari. Whatever he does with his body, mind, tongue, senses, reason, intellect, or by habit must be dedicated as offerings to the Lord. He should develop intense devotion. Thus, all his fears will disappear. He should hear the stories of the Lord, sing his praise, and develop non-attachment to objects through dispassion. Thus, the worldly enjoyments would have no taste for him, and he attains the greatest peace. That is the greatest gain to be sought for." King Nimi, "What are the qualities and activities of a devotee?" Sage Hari, "The foremost of devotees sees himself in all creatures and all creatures as established in his own self. A second-rate devotee is friendly to all other devotees of the Lord, compassionate to the ignorant and indifferent to his enemies. The best devotee makes no such difference among any of these. A devotee who worships an image but has no love for his devotees and other living beings is of a low order. A true devotee sees the whole universe as a manifestation of the Lord. Maya does not influence him. He has no attachments to pleasures or objects. He remembers the name of Sri Hari always. His heart is the permanent seat for the Lord." King Nimi, "What is Vishnu Maya?" Sage Antariksha, "O King, Maya is the inseparable energy or power of the Purusha, is otherwise known as Prakriti, which develops into Mahat Tattva with the 3 gunas, out of which ego is born as the Jiva with mind and indriyas, enjoys sense pleasures, functioning through the organs of perception and action in the body. The body is composed of the 5 elements. When dissolution takes place, all these merge back into Prakriti and Prakriti into Purusha." King Nimi, "How can Atman, having body consciousness, cross Maya?" Sage Prabuddha, "One must have the keenness to observe that all human efforts at obtaining pleasures through wife, children, wealth, property, etc. are capable of giving only temporary joy but lead to great pain in the end or even to death. The joys of the heavens too are transitory. So a man should beseech a guru who is a stotriya and brahmanishta and learn about the self, develop complete dispassion to objects, get himself attached to the devotees of the Lord, be humble, have friendship of and compassion for other beings. He should have purity of mind, control of speech, non-violence and evenness of mind during the onslaughts of the opposites. He should see the self everywhere. He must learn the scriptures, hear the stories of the Lord, perform sacrifices, serve the Lord's devotees, remember Him always, commune with Him, attain peace and be silent. His devotion develops into divine love and he crosses the Maya of the Lord. Raja Nimi, what is the nature of Brahman? Sage Pippalaina, Brahman is a cause for creation, sustenance and dissolution of the universe, and it is itself causeless. It exists in the states of waking, dream and deep sleep and in Turiya. Because of its immanence in the body, senses, mind and intellect function. Without it, these are incapable of any action. The Vedas too do not define Brahman except through negation. The uncreated Brahman became the Pradhana or Prakriti with three gunas and is called Sutratman and then the Mahat Tattva. He is again called Jiva or Ahankar. Brahman shines through the senses as the experiencer of the objects. Brahman has no birth, death or decay. It is the witness, omnipresent, pure consciousness. Brahman is clearly perceived by the devotee, devoted man of pure heart. Raja Nimi, how does a man cross beyond the bonds of karma and attain supreme knowledge? Sage Avirhotra, karma, akarma, vikarma mentioned in the Vedas have a deeper meaning called lakshyartha. In the beginning, Vedas promise fruits of action in order to create interest in the seeker. But essentially, actions must be performed for the pleasure of the Lord without attachment for the action or its fruits. This leads to knowledge and liberation from the reactions of karma. A man aspiring for liberation must follow the prescribed methods of worship. He must be pure in mind and body and approach the image of the Lord. He must worship Him in the 16 methods of worship. Offer sandal, flowers, incense, lights and food. Prostrate before Him with intense devotion. He will reach Him. Raja Nimi, what are the various activities the Supreme had performed? Sage Drumila, it may be an easy task to count the particles of dust on the earth, but to enumerate the actions of the Supreme is impossible. Lord Narayana is the original God. Out of Him the five elements came out. The universe is His body. The three worlds are His limbs, and action and knowledge are their functions. He is pure consciousness. By union with the Rajas, He is Brahma and creates. When dominated by Sattva, He is Vishnu and He protects the universe. With Tamas, He is Rudra and causes dissolution. He was born as Nara and Narayana and performed tapas at Badrikashramam. Indra wanted to spoil His tapas and sent Kamadeva, God of love, with many damsels. Narayana laughed at them and rubbed his thigh, brought out a damsel, Urvasi, and presented her to them. They were ashamed to look at the beauty of Urvasi and took her to Indra as a present, and his pride was put down. As the divine swan, as Dattatreya, as Shanaka and other similar sages, he preached self-knowledge to the ancient rishis. As Hayagriva, he killed the demon Madhu and brought back the Vedas. As fish, he saved the universe from the great deluge. As boar, he lifted the earth out of the waters. As tortoise, he helped in securing the nectar. As Narasimha, he killed Hiranyakashipu and saved Prahlada. As Vamana, he got back the kingdom of Indra. As Parashurama, he destroyed the wicked kings. As Sri Rama, he destroyed Ravana. After clearing all such doubts of the kings, the sages taught him the supreme knowledge and he attained liberation. On hearing this narration, Vasudeva and Devaki were greatly enlightened and pleased, and their presumption that Sri Krishna was their son got erased. The 16 methods of worship are 1. Avahana or welcome. 2. Asana or providing a seat. 3. Padya, washing the feet. 4. Argya or oblations. 5. Achamana or sipping water. 6. Snana or bathing. 7. Vastra or offering clothes. 8. Yajnopavita or sacred thread. 9. Gandha or sandal paste. 10. Pushpa or flowers. 11. Dupa or incense. 12. Deepa or light. 13. Naivedya or food. 14. Tambula or betel leaves. 15. Namaskara or prostrations. 16. Pradakshina or walking round. Perambulation.